The second-generation Vauxhall Insignia Country Tourer swells the ranks of mid-sized, rugged-ised, all-wheel drive estates. In this Mark II model, guise, this car gains a much more upmarket demeanour, with greater class, refinement and sophistication. Most significantly, there's the option of a torque vectoring all-wheel drive system that gives this car impressive on-road cornering prowess, especially in slippery conditions. In other words, there are all the ingredients for a rejuvenated product.
The exterior styling of this Country Tourer model may promise a crossover class driving experience, but behind the wheel, there's very little that's SUV-like about it. Still, not everyone likes a raised driving position. At speed through twisty tarmac turns, this Insignia's lower slung cockpit certainly feels preferable. And it's in this kind of motoring that this model's sophisticated all-wheel drive with torque vectoring system will come into its own. When you're cornering at speed, this ensures that more torque is sent to the outside rear wheel. That improves traction and ensures that there's far more of a feeling of precision when you're turning in. It works in concert with another standard country touring feature, Vauxhall's FlexRide driving modes and adaptive damping system. Now this not only tweaks steering feel, throttle response, and on the automatic models, gear shift timings to suit the way that you want to drive, but it also automatically adapts the car's damping to suit road conditions, cornering speed, vehicle movements, and an individual's driving style. Engine choice, that's between the two 2-litre diesel units, with most likely to select the 170 PS Blue injection engine, which can be ordered with either auto transmission or four-wheel drive, though unfortunately not both. This top 210 PS bi-turbo variant can be had with both of those things though, and it's a satisfying combination. Efficiency isn't a strong point though. This particular derivative manages only 39.8 mpg on the combined cycle and 188 grams per kilometre of CO2. As for off-road capability, well, you shouldn't expect too much of a car in this class, but this one could certainly tackle a light forest track that would damage an ordinary Insignia sports tourer thanks to a 20mm ride height increase over that car to 146mm. Now naturally, you'd expect a few design cues to distinguish your country tourer from a sports tourer, and Vauxhall delivers them. Here at the front, for example, the bumper is unique and it incorporates this lower silvered skid plate. The differences over the standard model are most evident in profile, where extended dark anthracite wheel arches and side sill extensions play the crossover card, and they attempt to emphasise this variant's 20mm increase in ride height. These smart 18-inch wheels are standard, and silvered roof rails provide a finishing touch while offering a carrying capacity of 100 kilos. Okay, enough with the aesthetics. This is an estate car and you're going to want to know just how practical it's going to be for your family needs. So let's take a look at that now. Now this optional powered tailgate can be set to the exact height of your garage ceiling, and it rises to reveal 560 litres of carriage space. If you want to carry longer items but you still need to take rear seat passengers, then this 40-20-40 split rear bench will be a boon, allowing you to easily push through lengthy items like skis. Dropping the rear bench, that can be done easily using these switches on either side of the cargo area walls, a process that frees up to 1,665 litres of fresh air should you need it. Time to take a seat up front, where there's an enormous improvement over what was served up by the previous Insignia. Fit and finish is almost a match for the premium brands, and in the instrument binnacle there's a smart and configurable colour screen, which is either 4.2 inches or, as in this case, 8 inches in size. Now anything that can't tell you will almost certainly be found on this centre dash IntelliLink infotainment monitor. Now on an Insignia model like this one that features navigation, this monitor is 8 inches in size, and as you'd expect, it's compatible with the latest Apple CarPlay and Android Auto phone connectivity systems, and it's activated via this projection screen option. More familiar infotainment inclusions run to the usual Bluetooth, DAB stereo and informational features. Talking of media connectivity, we also ought to cover the other key piece of standard technology which is available with this car, the OnStar Personal Connectivity and Service Assistant. Now, this includes a vehicle tracking system in case of theft. It creates in the Insignia an in-car Wi-Fi hotspot, and it'll allow you to monitor key information via a downloadable My Vauxhall smartphone app. OnStar will also automatically alert the emergency services if the airbags deploy. And if you press the system's blue button on the roof here, you'll be connected through to an operator who can find out just about any information you might need throughout your journey and can even download directions directly into the IntelliLink sat-nav system. Time to check out another area of this car that might really sell it to you. The back seat. And once inside, you really notice the benefit of this second generation model's extra 92 millimetres of wheelbase, as you'd expect from a car that's now nearly 5 metres in length, so nearly as long as an enormous Audi Q7 SUV. There's plenty of room for one really tall adult to sit behind another. The Vauxhall Insignia Country Tourer is a welcome addition to a market that has room for a talented mainstreamer with an attractive asking price. Other brands have shown how a capable estate of this sort can be a thinking person's alternative to a mid-sized SUV, and this Insignia delivers that concept with more technology and lower prices that probably have plenty of room for negotiation. That makes sense to us. If it adds up for you too, then an escape to the country could be one of the cleverer decisions you've made in a while.